Hey everyone. All right, so it's not really a tutorial. I get asked a lot about skincare, and like almost every video someone asks what kind of skincare I use or how I use it. And then in my Q&A video, I got tons of people asking about skincare. And then in my answers video, I mentioned how cleansing twice and moisturizing when your skin is damp are really good tips. And I got tons and tons of people sending me messages, emails, anything like that, and just telling me how much of a difference doing either one of those two steps made. So I thought I would do a skincare basics video. But before I say anything else, I'm going to say I'm in no way, shape, or form an expert when it comes to skincare. I just know what I personally know from the basics that I learned in cosmetology school, from what I learned from speaking to different estheticians, and just tips and tricks I learned online, stuff like that. And then another thing is, I'm not going to mention what products I use, like exact product names, because what works for me may or may not work for you. So I'm not going to tell you something's amazing and you have to get it if your skin is totally different than mine, because it's not going to work. So it's kind of, yeah, redonkulous. So let's just go ahead and start talking about some skincare stuff. There's only two steps, actually, for like the bare minimum basic. That's cleansing your skin and moisturizing your skin. After that, everything else is easy. 7 days a week, just cleanse your skin. A few things about skin cleansers though. A lot of people use something for like a few days or a week and they're like, it broke my skin out really bad, it's not working, and they stop using it. Your body takes 30 days to form an addiction or break an addiction, so you can incorporate that into skincare. It's going to take your body 30 days to actually adjust to the new product that you're using, so that first week when you use it and your skin breaks out really bad, your body's not used to it, but it's drawing out all that bad stuff out of your skin. So the second week it'll get a little bit better, third week it'll be even better. By the fourth week, if your skin is just horrible because this product made it worse, then you're definitely going to know by like the second week that it's not going to work out for you. So you definitely want to try to give all your new products at least a 30-day trial run. I know that sounds crazy, but you'll notice it's going to work in the long run. So again, 30 days, try it out. If it doesn't work after one use, not everything works after one use. Got to break it in a little bit. Your body's got to adjust to it. It's got to catch up to speed. I mentioned in the other video about cleansing twice and stuff like that. I'm going to talk about that later, but another thing is your pores. They do not open and close. In order for pores to open and close, they need to have a muscle, and we don't have little itty bitty tiny muscles on each pore on our face, because if you have that certain kind of muscle, it's a sphincter, and we all know what kind of muscle that is, and you don't have those on your pores. Pores actually soften and harden. So yeah, warm water will soften up your pores, cold water will harden them back up. So now you know that. That's like something people say all the time, and it really drives me crazy when I hear open and close, because they don't do that. If you wear makeup, you definitely want a very good skincare routine, because you want to make sure you get all that makeup off your skin, because it's not going to help it in any way, shape, or form when it comes to the actual skin. The appearance will look amazing, but you're going to be doing some damage if you don't wash it off. So make sure you wash it off. Silicone, caffeine, two very, very great ingredients to look for in different things for skin. Silicone is really great to fill in fine lines, help pores, stuff like that. I think most of you already know that. And then caffeine actually reduces puffiness, so it's a very great for under eye treatments, anything like that. Eye creams, if it's got caffeine in it, great. Try it out, see how that works. And then, believe it or not, another great treatment for under your eye is Preparation H, which we all know is for hemorrhoids, but that's puffiness. It's a bump, and it makes them go down. So, of course, it's going to work for the bags under your eyes. So if no eye creams are working, try Preparation H. Sounds kind of silly, but it works. Trust me, I actually keep some of it in my freelance kit, because some people have serious bags when you're going to do their makeup, and like that, it's fixed. So try it. A lot of people ask me what kind of shaving cream I use or how I shave and everything like that. For shaving, I love Max Shave Cream. Like, men can use it, women can use it. It's got sandalwood in it to help calm the skin down. It's got menthol to help calm the skin. And it's got something else in it as well. It's one of the C's, like calamine. I don't remember, one of those. But you don't need an aftershave with it, and it helps with shave bumps if you get those. So you really won't get them. So that's the one specific product that I would mention in this whole video, because anyone can use it. It works wonders for a lot of people. Everyone I recommend to use it say they love it, so definitely try that. If you go to MAC, you can actually ask for a sample. They'll give you a little sample container. I don't have one. Well, I have a pigment one on the desk in front of me. It's just a little guy like that, but you'll get enough in there for like one use in a sample. So there's a good way to try it before you buy it. I think it's only like $10 or $11. You get a lot, so it lasts a long time. Now we're talking about all the cleansing, moisturizing, exfoliating, and everything. For every skin type, you want to, 7 days a week, cleanse your skin, moisturize your skin, and twice a day. You want to try to do it twice a day, especially if you wear makeup, most definitely twice a day. I mentioned it in another video, when you cleanse your skin, cleanse it two times. The first cleansing actually removes all the dirt, oil, makeup, anything off of your skin. The second one actually cleanses the skin. So you actually use less each time. So take the amount of skincare you're using now, like cleanser, split it in half, use that the first time. You're not really going to get a lather or a foam from it because it's got all the dirt inside of it. And the second one, you actually get double the foam you've probably actually got. Like gotten any other time you've cleansed your skin, because you're actually doing it on very, very clean skin. Then if you use a toner, you're gonna tone after you cleanse your skin, and then your last step would be to moisturize your skin while it's still damp to help hold in the moisture. And you even want to do this if you have oily skin, because sometimes oily skin still needs moisture. If you strip too many oils out of your skin, your body's gonna produce more to try to make up for what it's lacking. So you may have dry skin, but it seems oily because you're stripping everything out and all that oil is showing. So does that make sense? It's true. I actually did it before a long time ago. That's 7 days a week though. And then once or twice a week, you also wanna bring in, like incorporate an exfoliator. And with this, I say 1 to 2 times a week. If you have oily skin, like real oily skin, your skin tends to be a little bit thicker than someone with a dry skin or sensitive skin, so you can go ahead and exfoliate twice a week. If you have dry skin, sensitive skin, you're only going to want to exfoliate once a week, so you don't want to go too overboard with it. If you can't afford an exfoliator, because some of them can be expensive if you like department store brands, even if you like drugstores, some people just can't afford that extra. They actually sell things at most places that sell cosmetics, like Target, Walgreens, stuff like that, like stores like that. Anywhere you can get a loofah pretty much, but they actually sell little round facial loofahs and facial buffs. Loofah's a little bit rougher than the facial buff. I prefer the facial buff, but what you can do with that if you can't afford an exfoliator, it's only like 97 cents, so anyone can buy it. You can use your regular skin cleanser and then just use that to lightly buff, and that way the loofah or facial buff is gonna help take off that little extra skin, any dry spots you have, just help with the exfoliating, and then the cleanser is going to go in and cleanse it. So there's like a little remedy to do your own exfoliator that helps tons of people. And then you can also do like masks. You can do those on your skin as well. Once a week, I like to do my exfoliator and my mask on the same day. There's a reason for that. When you actually stimulate the skin, it makes blood flow circulate a little bit better, and it actually brings more blood closer to the surface of your skin, so it helps bring all the nasty stuff that's in your pores closer to the surface of your skin. So I go in, I exfoliate, well, I cleanse, clean everything off, do it twice, then I exfoliate to go ahead, massage and stimulate everything. Then I'll apply my mask so it can grab onto everything that I just brought to the surface of my skin, rinse it off, moisturize. That's pretty much all I have for you guys with a basic of skincare. It's really simple. Just incorporate some of these things into what you already do now if you're having problems. And again, it's going to take some time to find out all the products that are going to be perfect for you. But like a rough draft of a week with skincare. On Sunday, you could do your cleansing and moisturizing. Monday, cleansing, exfoliator, mask, moisturizing. Tuesday, Wednesday, just cleanse and moisturize. Thursday, do what you did on Monday. Friday, Saturday, cleanse and moisturize. If you have more of a dry skin type, then maybe you're only going to do the exfoliator and the mask on Monday or Thursday or whatever day you pick. But that's pretty much it. So I hope this helps some of you guys, and I'll talk to all of you soon.